Shasta Darlington arrived in the city of Santa Maria a short while ago. She joins us now live. Can you describe the scene for us there, Shasta?
Yeah, Finola, it's just there's this overwhelming sense of chaos even now, hours later. As we drove in, ambulances were leaving, taking more patients out to the Army Hospital outside of town. We drove past another hospital where people, the family members were waiting to see if they could get in. And now we're at what used to be what is normally a municipal gym and has been turned into a makeshift morgue with more than 100 bodies inside. Again, mourning families outside, people looking for their loved ones. Because there's so many people in hospitals and because so many people were killed who weren't carrying their IDs, this is going to be a very long and painful process. We talked to some police here, some of the rescue workers, who said that a lot of the women don't have any IDs on them at all because they had left them in their purses. So they're having to take fingerprints. They're going to have to fly in families from all over the state to see if they can come and identify these people. It's just the whole town is so shook up and is still really in a state of shock, Finola.
And Shasta, the authorities are saying now that the permit for this club to operate expired last August. Are they saying anything about how they believe the fire may have started?
Well, there are a number of theories, Finola. People say that the fire started during a pyrotechnic show. One of the investigators I talked to said that during that show, someone fired a flare gun, believe it or not, up into the soundproofing insulation in the roof, and they believe that could have sparked it. But a lot of it is speculation. It's what the people inside the club saw until they actually do the sort of nuts and bolts investigation. It does seem pretty clear, though, that it started during this pyrotechnic show and that it could have something to do with that, Finola.
And we know that people were in the club, mainly students, celebrating the end of summer. Do we know how many people were in the club, and have the owners or people who survived been speaking out at all?
Well, Finola, so far we haven't heard from the owners, but this is a college town. There are four universities here, a lot of them from Santa Maria, a lot of them from around the southern region in Brazil. And again, yeah, like you said, it's the end of summer. People were out for that last hurrah, most of them in their late teens, early 20s, and just out for a good time. It sounds like maybe one person got out of hand and caused this whole tragedy. But at the same time, the club apparently didn't have all of their papers in order. And once the fire started, people simply could not get out. So there's going to be a lot of blame to go around here. Not something we want to start doing until we have the cold, hard facts, though, Finola.
And the president of Brazil, who was on a trip to Chile, cutting that trip short, coming back to say that as difficult as it is, that the people of Brazil and this town will get through this tragedy. But what do we know about the details here and now about arrangements perhaps being made to fly in victims or relatives of victims? Potentially, what do you expect to happen in the coming hours where you are in terms of trying to resolve the unidentified and their relatives?
Well, you can actually see it all going on around us. We also passed by the cemetery, and they're already, the cars are parked out in the middle of the road. They just go down the driveway. There isn't enough room for the cars at the cemetery, because those families that have identified their loved ones are already starting. They're preparing them for burial. So this is going to happen all fairly quickly. As soon as they can identify the victims, this is going to move ahead, and people are really going to begin the full mourning process. In the meantime, though, it's going to be painful trying to figure out if your sister is missing, if your son is missing. Is he in a hospital? Is he in the morgue? Maybe he survived and just hasn't been able to get through to you. There have been so many phone calls flying around. So there's a lot of confusion and a lot of worry, Finola.